Greetings, everyone. I believe this is part 8 or so. Just picking up where I left off. Which is... Let's see. Let's recap. So we had Doc and Spiffy divorced. Spiffy got a new lover that showed up out of nowhere. He instantly got eaten by a polar bear, which I find hilarious. I discovered this little bug where I can create gravel from water. Doesn't make much sense, but hey, you know. I already have a good little amount of growing room, and I'm just going to keep expanding it. And eventually I can turn this whole area to, you know, a farm or something. Looks like Africa. Nah, look at it. What else is going on? So English fell from the sky. Rescued her. And Steroid died. He died from this Muffalo manhunt pack, as did the calf. The calf got crushed to death. I actually didn't play very well during that whole event. I could have played it a lot smarter, but didn't. I didn't really use my turrets to its fullest. But, that's how it goes. So the next goal here is... Doc, you're already up. You're good to go as soon as you eat. Oh, don't cook, just eat, just eat, just eat. Alright, I'm gonna send Doc out. With the Muffalo. Up to my only outpost. I abandoned the other one. Oh, scratch that. Doc, forget what I just told you to do. Alright, so they're coming immediately. Sniper rifle Stars, why do you have that on? What weapon did Stars have anyway? Well, I'm missing something. Drop your personal shield. Not gonna have any use for that as a sniper. So, I played the Muffalo Swarm poorly, but I can play this well, and these are tribals, so... They're dangerous, but... Not nearly as dangerous as a full-court sniper shot. Ooh, goodbye, right hand. There's a lot of them, though. Say I wish I had steroids still around because I need a melee-er up front. Alright, Doc, you go. I need to add more doors, honestly. English, you pop your little head out. That one's gonna die. But not after I've done significant. Oh! English is dead. And they're giving up. I didn't really care much for English, I must say, so that doesn't dishearten me. If English is dead, I'm gonna have to bury her temporarily. see if there's any downed people that can be recruited. Not really. You're missing an ear. Join the club. Creepy breathing. No, thank you. No, not really. I mean, I've been picky. Maybe it will be my downfall. Because I'll just run out of people. You know, it's possible. It is entirely possible, but that's just the way I am. That's the way I'll play. I'll just keep being picky. Alright, how serious is your wound? Not serious, but, yeah, you can eat first. See any of these characters getting away? Would have been good to recruit. Not really. Him, maybe, but he's long gone. Well, that was a lot of attackers. I can safely say that I have repelled. Barrier quick. No need for all the mental instability of an unburied, Wow, that is down to 7? Jesus, caught a little close. I love how she's cleaning, yet they're still bleeding. It's like, rolling a stone up a hill. It's just, that's a task that it's not going to be finished anytime soon. Come on, make some kibble. Doc and Stars. Ha! Oh, I did not see that coming. Well, I mean, Stars. Spiffy, rather, probably does not like Stars. Nope. Well, I didn't see that coming, but they're similar, more similar in age than Spiffy. Spiffy's younger. Huh. Well, go figure. I have a lot of unowned beds. You know, I'm down to 3. Just dawned on me that, yeah, I don't have a lot of people in my little community nowadays. I really need to be adding. I need to be less picky about who I let join. Or just more careful with their lives. That's really what it is. She's high. Your rival died. That's funny. It's weird to think that people in this game are vindictive like that. Oh. I never in a million years would have thought Stars and Doc, but hey, it happened. Unique. Truly didn't think that would happen, but it did. Alright, this is the last fine meal I should be making. Back to kibble. It's weird to be making kibble with their own milk. But, you know, whatever. No, that's not what I wanted you to do. I want you to melt the bodies down. Doc, I don't need you to put butcher. I need more muffalo. That is plenty of muffalo. Spiffy, what do I want you to do? I forget. Oh, I want you to cremate. That's right. Killing these tribals creates a lot of junk. Quite a lot of junk. Wonder how much longer, people are going to survive here. It's getting to a point where I'm not entirely certain they have a lot of time left in them. Partially because, you know, I've been fast and loose for the sake of brevity, and partially because I've had a lot of bad luck. To be perfectly honest. Yeah. I mean, I don't think it's luck. I mean, the difficulty is high, so it's not. I can't chalk it up to luck. I mean, that wouldn't be fair. I am playing on a much harder difficulty, and given that, you know, I'm prone to harder events. But, you know, I think if I was on Randy Random, it'd be a bit harder. But the fact that I'm on Cassandra Classic, every time I suffer losses, Cassandra goes easy on me, whereas Randy wouldn't care. Randy is random. You know, that's the whole point. So, that, you know, that's just an interesting debate of how that would play out. And, you know, I'm thinking Randy would have been more difficult in this scenario. Now, most of my colonies that I normally make are much more successful than this one, because sea ice is pretty relentless. I mean, you're given almost nothing to work with, which is difficult. That's pretty difficult, especially on extreme difficulty. But that being said, you know, it could be worse. I could be playing, you know, if I was not recording for entertainment purposes, I could save scum. That would be easier, of course. Or I could, you know, accept more people in and use them as cannon fodder against the assaults that I face. Stuff like that. You know, stuff to make it easier. I do have this nice outpost here that I am slightly proud of. Vixen has somehow managed to keep herself fed, probably on hairs and... Oh, on all this meat. Yeah, that makes sense. But you can eat that meat, because now I have a pretty endless supply of muffalo. Which is nice. Oh, steroid. You did not wait very long for steroid to be in the ground for you to hop in bed with your new lover. For shame. But also, pretty enterprising. I mean, here's the thing. I can't really put myself in their shoes. I'm not in a life-or-death situation where one roaming pack of tribals will do me in. Maybe that makes you a little, you know, bond with people a little closer. I was going to say more loose, but that's not quite fair. The game has been tough. It's been very, very tough. It's been fun, though. I do like the increased challenge for sure. Yeah, I appreciate it. One little grow light. Probably shut that down for now. But I don't really need the power. Power's fine. And actually, I just got enough metal for another basin. So why not throw another one in? This is better sniper rifle. Go toss that on. Alright, so it seems to me I need to start selling stuff again. So I'm going to queue this up where they load everything I want to sell up in, and then I'll bring it to town the next day. So I'm going to get rid of all this elephant skin now they have all this muffalo leather. Muffalo leather, I think, is more insulating. I'm going to get rid of all the cycloid leaves. The insanity lance I'll keep just in case. So these people will buy my weapons. I don't have use of that spear anymore. My only melee has died. I'll keep the sniper rifle. Wow, personal shield 3%. I think that was on steroid when he got stomped to death. That's why I got so damaged. Ripped shirts, pretty low armor vest. Let's see. Dead people stuff. More dead people stuff. It's pretty easy to see how many people I end up killing, because I have a lot of stuff to sell constantly. And then maybe 2,000 silver. Not even going to bother queuing up a direction for them to leave, because there's no way I'm leaving today. It's too early. Or too late in the day, rather, for them to actually leave. I'm just loading it up for later. Plus, you know, I've got some colonists that are major break risks. I don't want them breaking in the middle of a convoy, and that would be very, very bad. It's too bad you can't just, like, tell one person to bow out of the convoy. Maybe you can. No, it doesn't seem like you can. Once you start it, you can only stop it. You can't edit it as you proceed. Let's see if I can move the muffalo. Once they're being interacted with, they kind of freeze. So it'd be more ideal if they're standing there, but whatever. Maybe tomorrow. Alright, extreme break risk, and the others are due for a minor. I think it's time to let them stop. Enjoy some dinner, and get some rest. Let's see. You really like him. Wow. Except for the fact that one is a drinker and the other is not. But you're actually not. Oh, that was steroid. That's right. So he's disfigured, but you still like him. Gotta keep those deep talks going, I guess. The disfigured has... oh, that's not... No, don't take it out. Oh, you suck, Stars. You suck badly. Man, this is... process to have to do over and over. And exit south. Yeah, see, they just keep moving. It's interesting. They move to like an agreed meeting spot, which is here. It's not even the center of the map. It's just like an arbitrary center of something. I don't know why they meet there. But then it causes my colonists to have to run. Oop. Goodbye. Have to run from corner to corner. I mean, it's really stupid. I don't... Oh, and now, because you're not part of their caravan, everyone else is back to doing whatever they want. Well, that was short binge. Man, it's going to take me 2 days just to load stuff into the caravan. That's a lot of junk. That's a lot of dead people. Have needs. You are a little hungry, so I'll let you roam. And now at daybreak, I'll send Doc to town. You're a little old, you're an empath, so you're probably not capable of violence. I'm gonna ignore you. Sorry. I've already brought the wrath of the tribes down on me. I don't need more. Oh, that's a Gavi, not Psychoid. Thieves. That's good to know. Alright, Doc, as soon as you eat, we'll be off. Doc, oops, that's not what I meant to do. Doc, going to town. Any additional stuff to bring? Oh, I could bring this leather. Skin. I don't know how many stacks that's in, but I'll just do it. Alright, looks good. Exit south. Stars is having a tough time. You lost a friend, you're in pain. You lost a husband. You lost a lot of your family that you're already over, but... I shit on her, but my god, she has been through the ringer. I only shit on her because she's a drunk. Ooh. Okay. All right. You cancel, and you cancel. I think I'll be able to get this one under control pretty quick. Maybe not. Oh, stars, why are you picking right now? To have a breakdown. I guess she's just been having breakdowns over and over and over. It's not just now, it's constantly. Alright, Doc, you get the stuff from the outside. She'll get the stuff from the inside. Fuck you, stars, come on. You're wallowing in your own self-pity while the whole base burns down. Alright, I need to invest in fire poppers pretty clearly. Oh, you're binge eating, too. You're just all sorts of special. Oh, thank you. Man, I cannot stop switching goddamn sides. Just one side. Gonna lock them in. Yeah. Screw the batteries. All right, there we go. Oh my God. Job's not done. Job's not done, ladies. Gent. Get that out of there. Keep the heat up. All in all, not, it could be worse. Oops. That should be connected now. No, it's not. That was rough, but okay. I mean, I'm alive. That's what I mean by okay. So everyone has like a dead lover or divorce. What a lovely little village I have here. Stars has catharsis times two and is still moody. My God. Life is not going well for you. You can feel free to enjoy the cloud watching. I don't care at this point. Vixen's been living off of meat I have up here. I don't really care. You can keep eating that meat. I got plenty down here. Right, Doc. Think it's time for you to take that trip now, buddy. Even though I haven't checked if you're hungry or thirsty or whatever, but at this point, I don't care. It's time for you to go. I've been trying to take this caravan trip like this whole week. That's how hard this difficulty is. You set yourself up with a simple goal. Just go caravanning. And then I've got a raid, I've got injuries, I've got diseases, I've got, so much shit happens. And you never get around to like the simple things. And that's why, yeah, like I'm almost 3 years later. I've got very little to show for 3 years of this. I just, it's tough. This difficulty is tough. I mean, I need to start building fire poppers everywhere, because fire is kind of the worst thing that can happen to this base, because my people are stupid and can't fight fires very effectively. I managed to save most of everything from the fire, which was good. But it still messed me up considerably. Making it there before he rests for the day. I haven't thought about this, but I buy someone, I should always be on the lookout for good slaves I can liberate. Especially given the amount of money I have, I can afford to buy some freedom. Or is it slavery? I don't know. I mean, for how many colonists I do lose, maybe they're better off being slaves to a tribe that doesn't seem to ever lose anyone. Alright, so that's a lot of stuff to buy. Is there anything I want from them? I won't mind some steel. Got some stuff to rebuild. Always buy components. Fertilized iguana eggs. Now, here's the thing. If I buy these and unload them inside, maybe that will work. And maybe I'll actually get iguanas. If it doesn't work, turn them into momeal. But maybe that will work. So I ended up spending money here. It's nice. Alright, so animals inside. This works. Gear. Still fertilized, hasn't been ruined with temperature that I know of. And it's on this one. Ruined by okay. Alright, I give up. I give up. Oh, steam. Just side beyond right. So now I'm living off of backup batteries. Not a good long-term solution, so I gotta get these batteries back up and running. With the steam, the steel I just bought. Also want to make a trip up north to bring that warg to market and grab as much steel up there as possible. So what temperature do these eggs have to be in? So I do believe they were in a nice temperature. One thing I could also do is, which I think is overdue, is create a trade beacon, but actually I'm not gonna put it there. Yeah, I'll put it here. Any good. Dumb labor? Nope. Sorry, you're just gonna lay there while I let you die. I know how that seems, but I'm a rotten person. Alright, talk, let's get this going. So yeah, one thing I haven't been doing is doing orbital trades, which would bring bionic parts and things like that. You know, I've been partially for the challenge, partially because I didn't really value orbital trades. I haven't been doing that kind of stuff, but I'm thinking about it now because I only have 3 people left and I need to start kicking my game up or I'm going to suffer long-term consequences of being a Luddite. Things are going slow. I know I'm being raided, but... Oh, because you killed my fox. Okay. That's nice. It's a fox I was never going to use. beat him down, man, I kind of wish I could save you now, because you took a beating from guys with clubs, and then you got back up. What a fox you are. So I'm just creating a giant roof. For the stockpile. I think I'm out of components. I have three. Oh, it's just because it's not counting. I'm not out of components, I'm just low. Alright, so what are you rating? You're killing my rat. It's fine, it's just one more creature that was going to eat my stuff. Let's see if the warg does anything. Because I like this little outpost. I don't want to see it burn. But it looks like they're attacking the random stuff I've claimed around. And leaving my base mostly unbothered. Why'd you go to sleep hungry? It just seems like a bad idea. Now I have the lovely need to move everything. Did you really just... Oh no, you ate first, okay. Thought she, like, built a snowman having not eaten. It's like, you're just asking for problems. Huh, there we go. They did not break into my actual base. They just broke into the outskirts. They even left Vixen untouched. Huh. And I just got a fine meal delivery up there. That's nice. Flare. Big deal. It's funny, I'm keeping a room entirely warmed all the time, thanks to a solar generator, a battery, and a heater that has miraculously not caught fire, because I don't have a fire foam popper there. I really do need one, but luckily I don't have a lot of equity here. I mean, if that burned down, okay, I lose some steel. Wouldn't be great, but wouldn't be the end of the world. Here is where I really need the fire foam popper. But I don't have a lot of steel here. So what I want to do is I want to, like, enclose this into its own little room. Enclose this into its own little room as well. But not really. I mean, the trouble is I can close it off here. But that's fine. This whole wearing worn out apparel is stupid. Drop it. Spiffy is meant to break. Yeah, it's not looking good for my... I mean, I'm hanging in there, but they're all sort of falling apart at the seams. Oh, you got back up. Holy hell. You are a crazy fox. Get beat down and gets back up twice. Oh, ha, he's back up again. incredible little fox there. I really should go up and save him. I mean, I'm honestly impressed. He attacked my invaders, even though I didn't tell him to. He got beaten up, got back up, got beaten up again, collapsed from exhaustion, got back up again. You know, when Doc wakes up, I think I'm going to go fetch that little guy. If I can. Off to go get him. Oh, yeah, because one battery is newer. All right, Doc, let's get up there. Spots. Great. One's hiding in their room, the other one's sad wandering. Well, I got ambushed by manhunters. Lovely. Well, that wasn't much of a threat. Let's see if I can carry that. Again. Oh, there we go. Ha! Sweet! It's good to know. Hope it was eaten. Spiffy's done wandering around, but is still in a horrible mood. God, they're both just terrible mood. And I am getting raided. That is just wonderful. Of course. Great. I have to kill teenagers. Hopefully, Stars gets done feeling bad for herself because she already lost. She already was not present for the last big upset. And I think she's going to be useless for this one, too. That's amazing. Well, Doc sleeps warm. Hell, he deserves it. Well, if I can kill enough of them out front, I can get them to leave. Oh, don't you break shit. Ah, great, the turret's shooting me. Oh my god, I'm gonna kill Stars myself. She was AWOL for the fire, and she's AWOL now. Alright, I don't think... Yep. I'm probably inside before you collapse for being slow. Oh, fantastic. Thanks for showing up the last minute of a fight. Oh, great. And the grave of your husband just got broken into while you felt sorry for yourself. Man, I really don't feel sorry for her. I mean, everything shitty happens to her, but my God, is she useless when I need her most. Spiffy did everything. Of course you did. Well, I don't have enough marble to rebuild that, Stars, so good job. Your husband is not buried anymore. All because you're a little pissy shit. Well, Doc. Oh my God. Are you kidding me? Collapse due to exhaustion while you're like holding medicine for your friend to just risk her life to save your lazy ass. Doc should be up soon there. He's up. He's feeding Hector. Don't butcher the... Oh, I guess it's fine. I thought it was rotten. Treatment. All right, Doc, there's no time for that. Any marble blocks up here to repair that sarcophagus? I don't see. That's limestone. Nope. Oh, that might be. Nope. That's marble, but not the blocks. Don't really have an interest in stone cutting. Alright. Gonna bury him in granite. I was going for a specific design idea, but the hell with that. What next are you butchering? Oh, warg. Alright, I'll let you butcher. So, world, create a caravan. Why? Oh, because you're holding the warg, that's right. So I'm going to leave the fine meals up there for whatever future excursions. But I'm going to be bringing everything else down with me. I can't even bring enough granite blocks to matter. That's fine. flip out about him not being buried. There, he's buried. Alright, sweet. Caravan's on the move. Hector is saved. He's the one-eared fox. With a pretty sweet story of being a badass. Like it. That is a fox I will train happily and feed happily. Because he's a badass. That agave fruit is spoiling soon. I don't want that. Alright, how am I doing on time? 50 minutes. Alright, play a little bit more and then call it for the session. So clearly the base has some security, let's call it flaws. To be fair, I'm constantly trying to make it look aesthetically pleasing and not particularly secure. That is in fact indeed my fault, something I will remedy when given enough time. If, you know, I survive. You're all rested up. Get moving. It's interesting. Kick you out of bed. Final straw was my husband died. Yeah, I get it. He died. Mr. Hector, you are getting trained, buddy. Oh, wow. It just won't let up. That's cool, though. Yeah, I didn't think I could tame him. But it was worth checking. How about you carry the agave? I haven't unloaded them. That's right. Really? Seriously? Deja friggin' vu. Alright, animals, get inside. I am not risking. Slow time down a little bit. Cheap shot. Doc's racking up a pretty good body count. Let's repair this door. Oh, nope. They're off the door now. Nope, they aren't. Okay. So I'm going to play this smart, unlike I did last time, and slowly, systematically exterminate all the Muffalo rather than just kind of prance around and get myself mauled or stomped to death. As you can see, it's working pretty well. I mean, it's surely bloody and gross. But... oh, come on, Muffalo, don't eat my rice. Well, I'm not going to be hungry anytime soon, at least not for buffalo meat. I honestly have enough buffalo meat at this point, as long as I don't have some sort of spoilage or fire for, like, years. Is that it? Nope, there's one more. And the Thrombo. Not entirely sure I want to throw down. You know what? To the victor goes the spoils. Thrombo dies too. I got those plasteel turrets that I'm going to make work. Who's Daisy? Doc? Oh, okay. Well, you did pick a good time, I suppose. The end of the... that could have been a lot worse. Work my colonists until they go crazy. I mean, this was more or less the psychic drone's fault. Once everyone's over their divorces and stuff, he's about to be over the divorce. Boom. That's pretty useful. Once they're all over, like, their dev loved ones and everything, I should stop having all these negative problems. So I've got, what, 10 days left on that. A whole season left on steroid. But a lot of the pain will go in about a week. That's a good start. What is... oh, Christ. That's it. Can you just get over yourself? You got headbutted. Ah, eating raw meat is terrible. Well, I can certainly bury people in sandstone now. That's what I'll do. Right, who can cook? Stars can cook a little bit. But I do want to clean up all this blood. Oh, my heater broke down. I'm pretty sure it's this one. Yep. Guess that doesn't really matter, though. I'll just need to go to the outpost with a component next time I leave. And there's no way I'm going to remember that, but whatever. Alright, well, I think it's a pretty good place to stop for now. I hope you enjoyed this segment. I'm going to pick the next segment up right when I left off, unless nothing interesting happens. So, yeah, look for part 9 soon. Or part 8? Part 9, yes.